Hello, welcome to this video. In the last video, we have discussed different applications of nanoparticles. Now, one nanomaterial that we are going to study is the carbon nanotube. So, in this video, we will see what is carbon nanotube. Okay, now we know in bulk there are different allotropes of carbon like graphite, diamond. We know their structure and properties. Similarly, at nanoscale also, we get different allotropes of carbon. So, one of the allotrope of carbon you might be knowing, that is the buckyball or fullerene. Okay. Now, what is the fullerene? It is made up of 60 carbon atoms. Okay, and these 60 carbon atoms are interconnected into hexagons like this. Okay, and these hexagons are connected into pentagon and hexagons. There are 12 pentagons and 20 hexagons. Okay, so you can see these are the carbon atoms, and this is the carbon atom, this is the carbon, and they are connected by covalent bond into pentagons and hexagons. So it gets the shape like saucer ball, and it is called as a fullerene or buckyball. Okay, so this is the one of the allotrope of carbon at nanoscale. Now, next allotrope of carbon, that is graphene, and then we go to carbon nanotube. Okay, notice the carbon nanotube. In 1991, Sumio Ijima, he discovered carbon nanotube. Okay, notice the carbon nanotube. See, carbon nanotube, it is a very thin, long cylinder made up of carbon. Here also, the carbon atoms are interconnected into hexagons. Okay, so before going to carbon nanotube, we must know what is graphene. Okay, so what is the graphene? It is one atom thick layer of carbon. They are interconnected into hexagons. Okay, so it is just important, you have to remember it. It is only one atom thick, and it is carbon atoms, only one atomic layer is there, and these carbon atoms are interconnected into hexagons, and then we get a plain sheet of carbon, and that is called as a graphene. Okay, so this is the graphene sheet. So this graphene was synthesized in 2004 by Andrei Jim and Konstantin Novoselov, and for that Nobel Prize in Physics was awarded to them in 2010. Okay, so this is the graphene. You can see these are the hexagons, and these carbon atoms are interconnected into hexagons, and it is only one layer of atom, and it is the graphene. Okay, now if you consider the thin paper, okay, so now we know paper is a plain sheet. Now this plain sheet of paper, it consists of number of atomic layers, about millions of atomic layers. Okay, and we know paper sheet is very thin, and it consists of millions of atomic layers, and here we have only one atomic layer. So you can imagine how thin is it. Okay, now when this thin sheet of graphene is rolled, then we get a tube like structure, or we get a cylinder like structure, and that is called as carbon nanotube. Okay, so what is the carbon nanotube? It is rolled up sheet of graphene. Okay, now we know the graphene. So here we can say that one carbon nanotube, it is one molecule made up of millions of carbon atoms. Okay, now we know the graphene, and this rolled up sheet of graphene is the carbon nanotube. And in one tube, there are millions of carbon atoms, and they are interconnected into hexagons, and they are connected by covalent bond. So we can say that one carbon nanotube is only one molecule, and therefore it is very strong with very high tensile strength. Okay. Now, based on the rolling, we can have different orientations of carbon nanotube. See, for example, see, this is the paper. All of you can see this paper. See, this is the plain sheet of paper. Now imagine this is the sheet of carbon nano. See, this is the length of paper. So I can roll it along the length like this. I can roll it along the length like this. Or this is the bread and I can roll it along the bread like this. Okay. So while rolling, we have to choose the direction or we have to choose the axis. Either you roll along the length like this or you roll it along the bread like this. Okay. Or you may choose a diagonal and we can have like this structure. Or we can have like this structure. Okay. So there are different orientations possible, and based on different, see, I show you with only one plain paper, so you cannot get the idea how structure changes, but I will show you now the diagram, so you will come to know based on rolling how the structure of carbon nanotube changes. Okay, so different orientations, see, these are the different orientations. See, this we call armchair. So you can see here, these are the hexagons and they form a line along the cylinder. See, this is the tube or this is the cylinder, and along the length of the cylinder we have the hexagons. This we call armchair. See, here we see we form a circle. This is the tube and these hexagons, they form a circle. So this we call zigzag and this is the chiral. Okay, so along no definite direction we roll it. So there is twist in the carbon nanotube and we do not get any definite pattern like this. Here we get a definite pattern that hexagons are along the line parallel to axis. Here hexagons, they form a circle around the axis, but there is no definite pattern here. So that we call chiral. Okay, so based on orientation, we have three different types of carbon nanotube. Okay, so how to draw these figures? So I will give you simple way to draw the figure. Okay, so first we see armchair. Okay, now we know armchair, see, these are the hexagons, they form a line. So along a line we draw the hexagons. Okay, so actually here just one line I have shown, but we know it is a tube. So this is the second line, I have shown only one hexagon. So this by blue line I have shown the structure. So this structure we can see it is just like a chair, and so we call it as an armchair. Okay, so this structure, so when you draw the diagram, you have to bold these lines to show the armchair structure. Okay, so this is the armchair, these hexagons, they form a line and that is parallel to axis of CNT. CNT, that is carbon nanotube. Okay, now this is the zigzag. Okay, now in zigzag, we know the hexagons, they form a circle around the axis. So we get this zigzag structure. So by blue line, again, I have shown this zigzag line. So you have to make it bold. So this is the zigzag. Okay. And the last one is chiral. There is twist to the nanotube. So we do not get any definite pattern, and that we call as chiral. Okay. So based on orientation, there are three types of carbon nanotube: armchair, zigzag and chiral. Okay, again we have two different types of carbon nanotube. Okay, so this is single walled nanotube. So single wall, the name suggests, here we have only one tube, one CNT. Okay, and the ends of these tubes are closed by half of the buckyball or fullerene molecule. So what is the buckyball? In the beginning we have seen it. Okay, and then we have multi-walled. So this is the single wall. So single wall means only one tube we have, and this is the multi-walled, means number of carbon nanotubes, one inside the other, or we can say all those are coaxial. Okay, so there are number of carbon nanotubes, coaxial carbon nanotubes. So here it is multi-walled carbon nanotube. Okay, so there are about 50 carbon nanotubes are there, and the distance between two successive CNTs is in nanometer, about 0.34 nanometer. Okay, so this is about the carbon nanotube. So what is the carbon nanotube we have seen? It is one molecule. One nanotube is one molecule. The diameter of the carbon nanotube is in nanometer, while its length it may be in millimeter. One tube is one molecule, and therefore it is very strong. So it is rolled up sheet of graphene. So based on rolling, there are three types: armchair, zigzag, and chiral. And again, there are two types: single-walled carbon nanotube and multi-walled carbon nanotube. Okay, so this is about carbon nanotube. So okay, friends, we stop here. In the next, we will discuss about the properties and applications of carbon nanotube. Okay, thank you.